Hey friends, welcome to the channel. And in this video, I am going to discuss about Claisen rearrangement. Now, Claisen rearrangement are of several types. There are several variations of the Claisen rearrangement. So, namely, you can see this is normal Claisen rearrangement, then Aza-Claisen rearrangement, then Eastern-Mosher Claisen rearrangement, then Ireland Claisen rearrangement, then Johnson Claisen rearrangement, Thio-Claisen rearrangement, and Tishchenko-Claisen reaction. So, seven reactions are there of the name of Claisen. And they are mechanistically they are same, but there are slight variation is there. So I will discuss all these seven reactions, and for that I may make two videos, because if I may make one video that will be too longer. Now before going to the problem reaction, I would make one announcement that recently I created a Facebook page on the same name, Chemistry Lover. So I'm requesting you to like that page, because you know, when I solve some problem, it is not always possible for me to upload all the problem as a video. So if you like that page and you are connected with me, I can upload, I can take a photograph of that problem and upload on the Facebook page, or some important documents, some notification, I can upload there, because uploading Facebook is very easy. So if you want, you can follow me on that Facebook page. So now let's so I will put the link of the Facebook page on the description section and also on the comment section. So now let's start the reaction. So if I talk about Claisen rearrangement, it is a 3-3 sigmatropic 3-3 sigmatropic rearrangement reaction, and you can see, so it involves a allyl vinyl ether. So let's say you have this allyl vinyl ether. So you can see this is vinyl part, this is allyl part, and it rearranges to a gamma delta unsaturated ketone or aldehyde. So in so here, if you have R group, so you will get this, so alpha beta gamma. So you can see alpha beta gamma, so gamma delta unsaturated aldehyde, you will aldehyde or ketone you will get. Now how the reaction occurs, so you can write this allyl vinyl ether like this. Okay, now you can see this is 1, 2, 3, and this is 1, 2, 3. Why I am writing like this? Because this bond will be broken. You can see I can write a arrow pushing mechanism, but this is not accurate for pericyclic reaction. Still, this is a normal way to represent the reaction, and you can see this bond is breaking. So I already told in my video on pericyclic reaction that whenever you are drawing a sigmatropic reaction, you have to know number the atoms from the from where the bond is forming and where the previous bond is breaking. So here the bond is breaking, so we have 1, 2, 3 and 1, 2, 3. So this is 3-3 sigmatropic rearrangement, and you can see here you will be getting this R will be here. Now a new bond is forming here, so you will have this keto group here, and here you will have this double bond, new double bond. So you can see this is alpha to the carbonyl group, so this is alpha beta gamma. So you can see gamma delta unsaturated carbonyl compound. So here I did a mistake. Actually, it will be this compound. So you can see here you will have this compound you will get. So I did a mistake, because so now if you have a R group here, then here you will have a R group and you will get ketone. So according to the presence of this R group or not, you will get aldehyde or ketone. So this is the basic mechanism of the Claisen ester, Claisen rearrangement. This is a sigmatropic rearrangement. Now actually this reaction which I draw here, it goes through a cyclic chair-like transition state. So that you can also write. So you may give this oxygen here, and this is how your trial like transition state will look like. Now you can see this part, you can write. Now here you will have double bond, so another bond will be there. And now here you have this group. Now this side here you will have a bond, and here you will have another bond. So now you can see if you put another group here, and if so this is I am representing both this double bond as trans. You can see this is a trans double bond, this is also a trans double bond, and you have to maintain that stereochemistry here also. So if you want to make trans, this group will be here, and here if you want to make trans, this R group will be here. So after reaction, what you will get, you will get this. So here you will have this R group, and now here you will have this CO group here and this R group here. Now you can see the stereochemistry of these two centers. You can see it is determined by this transition state. This is these two centers, the stereochemistry, this cannot have any arbitrary stereochemistry. So according to the stereochemistry of your starting material, if it was cis instead, so let's say if this group was cis, so then this R will be here, and you have to put this group here. So now you can see the stereochemistry will be changed. So you have to take care about the stereochemistry of these two centers, because it is dependent on the initial stereochemistry, and you have to always draw this chair-like transition state, and then only you can predict which stereochemistry you will get after the reaction. Okay. Now this is very important reaction. This is the normal Claisen rearrangement. Now next, so what you get? You get from a allyl vinyl ether, you get a gamma delta unsaturated. So you get a gamma delta unsaturated ketone or aldehyde. Now let us talk about the next reaction, that is Claisen, that is the Johnson-Claisen rearrangement. Okay, so what happens for Johnson? It is also called Johnson-Claisen orthoester rearrangement. So in this case, what you have? You have this allyl, you have this allyl alcohol. So you can see this is allylic position actually here. Okay, so this is allyl alcohol, and you treat this allyl alcohol with orthoester. Orthoester means, let's say, triethyl orthoacetate. So this is the structure of triethyl orthoacetate, and in presence of weak acid. So what happens for triethyl orthoacetate in weak acid? So the weak acid will first protonate one of this ethoxy group, and this lone pair will push and it will go away. So what you will get? You will get this type of intermediate. Now you can see this oxygen lone pair can attack here to form this. So you will have this OET here and OET here. Now you can see in acid medium another OET group can be protonated, then again this oxygen will push and it will go as ethanol. Now you can see here you have ethanol, sorry, in this case ethanol is going, and here you have positive charge. Now this hydrogen can be eliminated, and out of that you will get this oxygen, and here you will have this double bond, here you will have this OET2. So now you can see the same situation like this allyl vinyl ether, which is used for Claisen rearrangement. This is prepared in situ. So now it can undergo this 3-3 sigmatropic rearrangement, and you will get this compound. So in this case also you get alpha, so gamma, this is gamma delta, so gamma delta unsaturated carbon compound, and after hydrolysis of this compound you can get acid also. So this is variation of Claisen rearrangement, but the basic mechanism and the basic outcome is same. Now next let us talk about Claisen. So this is Claisen Johnson orchestra. Now let us talk about the Ireland Claisen rearrangement. So in the case of Ireland Claisen rearrangement, what is used is this allyl ester. So let's say you have an allyl ester. So you can see this ester, there is a double bond in the allylic. In the allylic position of this double bond, there is a ester group. So this is called allylic ester. When this allylic ester is treated with base, let's say triethyl amine, like weak base, and you have TMS, let's say TMSCl, trimethyl silyl group. So silyl reagent is used in this case. So this is your allyl ester. Now for undergoing Claisen rearrangement, here it should have hydrogen. So it can be methyl group or any other group, but here this alpha position of this carbon group, here it should have a hydrogen. So what will happen, this triethyl amine will take this hydrogen, it will go here, and now this oxygen will attack on TMSCl or any other silyl halide can be used. So it will give you silyl enol ether. Okay, so you get the silyl enol. Now again you can see this allyl vinyl type intermediate is produced. So it can undergo the Claisen rearrangement to give you the product. This oxygen, here you have OTMS. Now when you hydrolyze it with standard reagent for removing of the TMS group is TMAP, tetrabutyl ammonium fluoride. So the fluoride F minus will attack here and you will get the ester. So ester is hydrolyzed and you will get acid. So in this case again the product is a gamma delta, so alpha beta gamma delta unsaturated carbon compound, but in this case you get acid. So these are the three reactions of that is Claisen. This is called Claisen-Ireland rearrangement. It is also very important, and the next reaction I will discuss in this video is the Thio-Claisen rearrangement. So Thio-Claisen rearrangement is just the normal Claisen rearrangement, but so what you have for Claisen rearrangement is allyl vinyl ether. So you just replace this oxygen by sulfur. This is called thio. Now this is thio ether, and the thio ether can also undergo this Claisen 1,3,3 sigmatropic Claisen rearrangement, and you will get this thio carbonyl or thio carbonyl compound. So this is called Thio-Claisen rearrangement. Now I will stop this video at this point, and in the next video I will discuss the remaining three reactions and along with some questions from the CSIR exam. So for that you have to subscribe my channel, and if you like my video then give thumbs up, and thank you for watching.